After we take out the enemy labs, this island would make for some nice beachfront property.
Hey guys, today we are watching this 1v1 between me, Blaze, and Alexander on vacation. This is part 2 to our 1v1 from the other day, which got ruined by disconnect. So here's the rematch to see who wins. The long-awaited rematch, I might add. The legendary showdown between the two conquerors, Alexander the Great and Julius Caesar.
Ready, boss. Ready, boss.
Let's see who's gonna conquer this little island and turn it into some nice beachfront property, shall we?
Hello?
Got purple henchmen walking through this nice tropical pathway. Bit of a scout running through. Not sure what he's checking for, but he's here.
Ready, boss.
Got a wrench red henchman following him back.
Ready, boss.
Trying to punch him out.
Hello.
Alexander with level 2, and he's got a chamber going up at the same time. Very good. Here come the units. Short range 2, the level 2 range unit. Babu Chameleon with Pack Hunter. 16 range, not bad, but yes, it is short range. And we got a Pack Hunter, giving it a little bit of extra punch. There's Blaze with the level 2, just a little bit behind. Alexander does have a few units on the field already. This henchman punching. These units are actually doing a pretty good job. But here comes the melee, the Feral Wolves with the High Endurance Frenzy. That speed is pretty nuts too with the frenzy.
Ready, boys.
Alexander has the initiative here, but looks like Blaze is doing a good job of pushing him back with the use of the melee. These melee in numbers, if they can get a surround on the range units, they can do good damage, but the range units can very effectively kite back and get free picks. This is quite a big force for Alexander here. This is a bit scary if you're purple here. And I was purple, so I can tell you it was pretty scary staring down this massive pack of baboons. But here's the Sonic. The area damage does a number on these tightly packed units. Sonic in general being pretty good against mass range, especially when the Sonic units have larger range. Oh, and look at that, you see 4-5 baboons die at once. So that does the trick right there. This is a defensible position set up for purple now. And these things have regeneration, which makes them very good defensive units. Purple is also fenced off top. So all the aggression is funneled through this way. The baboons going around top, perhaps looking for another point of attack because he noticed and realized that he can't break this position anymore with the Sunbeam Towers and Sonic. One wolf out here. Knocking at the door. But won't get taken out by the sound beam. And we have this small pack of baboons breaking through the fence. But Blaze responding with the sound beam tower and sending some units up this way, which should be more than enough to hold them off. Looks like this chamber's rallied up here as well. Some more chambers going on. But the expo. And these baboons do get wiped out. The generator has been built. Alexander has not taken his water geyser yet. Blaze is already 30% of the way to level 3. Alexander ahead of him though at 55%. The big economic difference is that Alexander is not active at this expo. He has a workshop there, but no henchman mining. Whereas Blaze has basically fully staffed expo, plus the water geyser. So considerable economic advantage for Blaze right now. Both players level 3 now. Alexander's got some sneaky proxy chambers up here, and he's producing the Cannon 3. Pretty strong unit. Low speed, but lots of health, lots of damage, good defense. A powerful siege unit. And these chimps just kind of harassing, pulling the henchmen off mining to come punch. Here come the Muscipines, classic unit that I love using. Setting up a lot of fortifications here.
Ready, boys.
Looks like Purple's plan is to block this pathway off and focus all aggression through this way. These proxy chambers with the camouflage units are being pretty effective here, because these units can just sneak through and hit priority targets. But there are a few creatures around here and Sounder Tower. The Walkstrich being able to take down the cannons. It's high melee damage. More towers going up. And in the meantime, these proxy chambers have been found out and dismantled. This point, Alexander's still missing his water geyser. He might not even have realized it's there. Sometimes new players don't notice that water geyser on vacation. You have to zoom out your map to see it. That wolf unfortunately going down, but he did his job. There's level 4 being started for Purple, and a gyro drop on Alexander's expo. A few walk stretch. These fences are actually doing a pretty good job, kind of just being in the way. But down go the sound beams. Looks like these ones are kind of stuck here, not really able to get through. Just chomping on the clinic. And these sound beam towers are fenced off well enough that these walkstriches can't easily get through. So look like Alexander is going to be able to hold off against this. Just getting shredded by the sound beams, love to see it. In the meantime, Blaze has pushed down the main pathway to Alexander's lab. Fences again doing a good job. Alexander seems to be very good at using fences and structures to build defensive formations. Love to see that. Now if he had a mass of artillery up on this hill or something, then this would be a pretty well defended position. But he's just lacking creatures right now. Not having this generator does play a big part in that. There's Blaze at level 4. There's another gyro drop. Walkstrich is backed up by Muscupines this time. And going around this way, so they're going to be able to access the Soundbeam Towers.
Hello.
Alexander was able to somewhat hold off this attack here, but and the head shield doing good work as well. But now his expo is really under pressure.
Ready, boss.
Especially now that the Muscupines are moving in finally. All the Soundbeam Towers are destroyed just about. More going up here, but I don't know if he's going to be able to hold this off anymore. The henchmen are falling.
Hello.
And Blaze has now swung around to grab this generator. And he's really pushing into the base. Broken through the fences here, created a gap for his melee to go in. Still a pretty good defensive formation. Lots of range units, Soundbeam Towers, and good blocking of the choke, so it's not an easy nut to crack here, but the expo has fallen, and that's game. Alright, that was a good game. As for the rest of the game, I'll do man dirty, man I get two time. To me, that's just our side. I don't really care who rides on whose side. Bring 10 shots to the poolside. Never seen none of these grown men outside. 4301 won't spare no one. Niggas got to know about Southside. Stepping out of line, get outline. And you know I'm tied up stateside. Ringing man down when it takes sides. Trying to get saved by the bell like Bayside. Prince, I carry that last name. That shit stays on me like brand names. Jazz just lined up brand new hantings. The nice guy on a mad team. Everyone I know has code names. Anyone I'm beefing with is a no name. Niggas can't even win home games. They just got to fall in line like Soul Train.